Yo, welcome back to the Prez 7 at 7. Your host, Videographer Prez. I'm right in front of Plank Eye Skateshop down here in Bellevue, Pennsylvania. We're about to run in here and get an interview with the manager, Brian. But first, we'll cut to videos from AF Rome. Shout out to Red Nation and Sauce Called 40s. So check the video out. Follow my man AF Rome on Twitter, yo. Let's go.
What's up, world? It's AF Rome, and I came here with my 40, but don't get it twisted. Budweiser delicious, that malt liquor. I don't fuck with it, man. Fuck with us. Party so loud, po-po try come get us, and I be like, wait, wait, wait. Okay, now pass the Dutch. This a smoke friendly house, they ain't mad when we rolling up. Couple girls in this bitch want attention, but my girl right here, long hair, looking bad as fuck. I tell her I don't need them, cause I got you, babe. So raise your 40 like we pop champagne. And my niggas here too, and ain't really tryna pop them things. So let's have a good time today. That's right, there's more of those in that fridge. Take that outside with them squares. I know I said the smoke in here, but word to his, them six we smelling for years. I swear when you looking like me, you gotta smile. I have fun, I get paid like. Stack it, bam. Stack it, bam. Stack it, bam. Let's play that fun life, we bout it, nigga. Party like we in college, nigga. 40 nights with 40s ice, can you handle it? I doubt it, nigga. 2 a.m. and I'm wired. 5 a.m. now I'm tired. I take my girl back to the room, then proceed to pound it.
Go, 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 yeah, we gon' party all night. And we gon' smoke a few up in the morning. Good vibes, got the whole room. When you going in
40s, shorties, 40s, shorties, 40s, shorties, 40s, shorties, 40s, shorties, 40s, shorties, 40s, shorties.
Hey, welcome back, Spread 7-7. Right now I'm inside Plank Eye with the owner, Brian. What's going on, sir? How's everything? He's opened shop in 2008, right down here in Bellevue. So tell us a little background about why you opened the shop, bro.
So, in 2008, opened a shop down the street, and we got this big GC Murphy building with my buddy Carla. Landlord went out of business, so we had to move over here, so about two blocks down. We've been in business 5-6 years since then, pushing for that skate plaza for about 3 of those years, and thankful that it's finally built up there.
Let's talk about the skate pause a little bit. So you say you've been pushing for like the past 3 years for it to be built?
Yeah, we went through about like 3 years of going to like council meetings pretty much once a month, talking to all the local borough council members and just really like pushing for that, going through like waiting anxiously through like votes and getting right. Parents to come forward and speak right. up and stuff. So
definitely. So now like the inside of the shop, like you've got all skateboards in here. So yeah. It's like, is it more of a skateboard shop opposed to like, you know, some people have clothes over the place of their skateboard shop, but you just basically stuck to the realm of having a shop.
Right, yeah. You pretty much said it. I'm here mostly to try to get you on a skateboard and just having a good time on a skateboard. So we have everything you could think of for skateboarding. Don't do too well with the clothing. But don't mind selling clothing. But yeah, for the most part, we're all about skateboards.
Real quick, what's the name, Plank Eye? Where'd you get that from?
So it comes from a Bible verse, actually. Personally, I just wanted to make sure I didn't forget God as I like started out in this business and like get crazy busy and sucked into like business. Didn't want to forget God when I was doing that. But right. Basically, it comes from recognizing that like I was a hypocrite and like very judgmental. And there's the verse in the Bible goes, who are you to complain about the speck of dust in your brother's eye when you have a plank in your own eye? And it says, first take the plank out of your eyes, and then you can see clearly to help your brother remove the speck of dust from his eye. So it's pretty much a warning against hypocrisy, a warning against being judgmental. And it kind of like really applies to even a lot of what happened on like the macro level within Bellevue as far as we don't want those type of kids in our neighborhood. We don't want those type of kids in our park. We don't want to foster or encourage that environment. And a lot of that was like pretty heavy. Like it's kind of the underlying subliminal. Like when you're talking to politicians about like, oh well, so why isn't this park happening?
Right.
You know, the bottom line is like those kids might be drug addicts and we don't want drugs in our town. Mm. So we're casting judgment against that, and we'll say it's insurance, or we'll say it's something else that isn't quite the issue. It's kind of like, keep yourself true, be able to look at yourself in the mirror at the end of the day.
That's cool, man. That's cool. I'm glad you incorporated God into everything that you do. That's dope. That's good. That's very spiritual, too.
Yeah.
That's what's up, man. So we about to go to another video. It's from my man, Ben LB. He's out in Los Angeles. The song's called WFL, Word of Free Life. So check out the video. We'll be back, yo. It's the Prez 7-7. Enjoy yourself.
Overlooking life, trying to find one. Stuck, scared to live life, yeah, I've been there. Grab my nuts like, fuck it, we ain't here. Everything to gain, everything to lose. Call it how you see it, been what it's been. Fuck y'all, me and my niggas, we just can't win. ATM click, think money if you wanna win. Keep asking to the young niggas, sell a soul. Heard money over bitches, be the real goal. This my city, fuck you was born. Born ass niggas, petty ass bitches. All this surrounded by because of my riches. Unlike y'all, do a nigga still focus? Want favors, you wanna know this. Black guy, that's it for fame. Crazy part is I never catch her name. Truth be told, she the
we get it on. Shout out to my brother Pound, you know the word, my second home. I'm ballin' hard, I'm flexin' homes. It's my movie, no extra homes. I'm ballin' hard, I'm flexin' homes. It's my movie, no extra homes.
Welcome back to the Prez 7-7. It's your man, Vehicle Prez. Right now, chilling out with the man of the hour, you know what I'm saying, director of Pittsburgh videos and everything else, Ben Fredette. What's going on, sir? How you doing?
Good.
Good to finally come down, have an interview with you, talk to you for a minute. Basically, man, tell him, like, when did you start getting to the videos, man?
I, like, getting a camera-wise, like, sixth grade, I went to summer camp in the Poconos, and, they had, like, a whole activity about, like, make your own music video where, like, the counselors filmed you and, like, they turned my bunk into, like, a boy band. And I watched them, like, edit the video, and that was, like, seemed cool. And then I started making stuff with my friends, like, crazy basketball shot videos and then eventually music videos, films, and whatnot.
Cool. So, yeah. So you're originally from New Jersey.
Yeah.
And came to Point Park. Twitter got you popping because you was doing videos out here. So, man, like I was saying, starting the videos, doing your thing like that, who was one of the first people that reached out to you to do a video?
One of the first artists I worked with here was John Quest. Shout out John Quest. And we did a season 2 intro for one of his, I think, the Adventures of Johnny Quest season 2. And I met BD through that. And then I did the White video, like, early in my first year here. And then 58's B White kind of got my name out there because he has a huge buzz around here. So
yeah, he was doing a lot of videos with the 58s.
Yeah, they're probably
a lot of videos from
there. They're like the one group I really like believe in. I feel like their music can reach somewhere outside of Pittsburgh.
Yeah,
that's why we're about to do Mon Valley Mondays, which was a like a video series we did every video every Monday last year, and we're gonna try to start it back up. I think we did about 8 weeks straight last year, new music videos every week.
Yeah, that's when I first saw Billy that way, Mayo. Man. That's when I first saw Mayo.
Shout out Mayo.
Shout out Mayo. Yeah. Hey yo, Mayo's funny as heck. Yo, follow him on Twitter at Mayo58. So he's hilarious.
For all the live action.
Yo, he's hilarious on Twitter. Yo. I laugh every day. I'm gonna unfollow everyone else. He's gonna follow Mayo. I swear. Man,
really?
In real life.
Everything.
But nah, man. Like doing these videos. Like, what's some of the favorite? Your favorite like times like behind the camera, like stuff that you witnessed.
Definitely doing I'm Shmacked. Shout out I'm Shmacked. They give me a lot of opportunities to travel and go other places. And I was just in East Carolina this weekend where it was crazy. I go to art school, so I got to witness like tailgating and like college pool parties and shit and like crazy shit. It was fun. Like, yeah, and so they've definitely given me a lot of opportunities to do a lot of things.
Dope, man. So y'all need to make sure, all right? Make sure y'all check him out on Twitter at Ben Fredette. Check out all his catalog on YouTube. Follow him on every channel because he's dope as heck. Make sure you check out his reel. We're about to shoot to it right now. This is production reel coming up. My man Ben Fredette in the building. Press 7-7, all right? Don't go nowhere.
Thank you, sir.
No problem. Welcome back to the Prez Show, Prez 7-7, right here at the skate park hanging out. Yo, make sure y'all tune into my show, listendiamond.com, every Monday from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. The Prez Show Live, hashtag that thing. All right, next video we'll go to is my man Tope. He's out of Baltimore, Maryland. His joint's called Welcome to the Lion's Den. So shout out to my homie Tope, man. Keep doing your thing, all right? Testing the king. Let's go.
Yeah. It's Tope. like I never left. Headed for the throne, took a king step. This beat put it to his death. That's what it gets for trying to test. Same goes through all the rest. All you lame rappers get the same specs. Haters better hit the deck like I'm a crazy young man with a load of tech. Rap game gets no neglect. Looking like prey aiming for the neck. King strike straight to the head. Clawed all up all across the chest. No thoughts of making a mess. Put my teeth to the metal, rip through his flesh. Won't stop till I'm one of the best. Even after that, till I'm laid to rest. Around the clock, that's how I know to win. Got these lyrical bullets with a loaded pen. Around the clock, that's how I know to win. Anything less than that, to the lines then. Around the clock, that's how I know to win. Got these lyrical bullets with a loaded pen. Around the clock, that's how I know to win. Anything less than that, to the lines then. Toss them up, I'ma chew them down. Getting type of buck, I'ma glue them out. Accent that I work in the South. Then in Houston as a kid, I used to run my mouth. Used to live in Cali, shout out to the West. San Bernardino, here's my respect. Rhode Island's where King was born. So without being said, shout out to the North. Be more where the rest was made. Gotta thank God for the milk for days. American but Nigerian raised. Never break ties with my
Yo, welcome back. It's Prez 7 at 7. Right now hanging out, you know what I'm saying? I was gonna do a couple tricks, but I lost my board. So that's done, okay? Maybe next time. But the next video we'll go to is my homies The Wave, Jose Wavy, and Wave and Lane. Yo, keep doing y'all thing. The joint's called Notre Dame. So check it out. Don't go anywhere. It's the Prez 7 at 7. We'll be right back, all right?
I be smoking, never stressing. Ain't no second guessing. I be riding on a wave like my name is Kelly Slater. I ain't worried about a hater.
Nah.
I ain't worried about a hater.
Nah.
I be smoking, never stressing. Ain't no second guessing. I be riding on a wave like my name is Kelly Slater. I ain't worried about a hater.
Nah.
I ain't worried about a hater. Complex, mind state, MK on that
timepiece.
Gold blocks, cold nights, my name ring in
my streets.
I came up with one goal, grind hard, cannot fold. Counterfeit and niggas know that we a hard act to follow. And that's content or that show life. Don't hate me,
hate your life.
Cause I'm out the house and you on the couch with a pocket full of dust mites. Motivated by dollars chasing, my reefer it be concentrated. And shit from Vegas backstage, getting high with the nigga Wiz. It ain't all about the money, but who let you win? Y'all niggas see it, never bragging, I'm just stating facts. I know you hate it when she say, babe, play that way shit back. I be smoking, never stressing. Ain't no second guessing. I be riding on a wave like my name is Kelly Slater. I ain't worried about it.
Yo, Prez 7 at 7, what's going on? Hey, I got my longboard. I'm not doing any tricks with this. I'm just going to cruise around the city. But the next video coming up is going to be my man Ricky. His joint's called No Mind. Check the video out. Don't go nowhere. It's Prez 7 at 7. Hang out, all right?
But I love this shit. My circle tight, wanted no draft pick. I body slam these beats, I'm Randy Savage. I do this music shit for me and all my niggas. Stack it up, break bread to all my niggas. I always told myself that I'm gon' see them figures. I wishin' he was here, I'm pissed they killed my nigga. Only time will tell. Either do this rap or rap another bell. Selling bread, brick, even hold one stale. No man, nigga, I ain't never gonna tell. Free little Donnie till bro hit the streets. I'ma hold it down till you get unleashed. Still underground, who grounded like me? Never gonna change, I'ma say same OG.
Me and my niggas ain't got no mind. Me and my niggas ain't got no mind. Me and my niggas ain't got no mind.
What's up, man? It's Prez 77, host of Videographer Prez. Finally got my man Grits. What's going on, sir?
What's
Grits good? Capone out here. You know what I'm saying? He's doing a lot of different work out here in the city. Woo. From volunteer work with the kids to rapping. Also doing spoken word with Morris Jackson. So, Grits, man, like, tell us a little bit about the background of Grits Capone. Like, when did you start doing the spoken word?
Okay, I've been doing spoken word poetry since I was about maybe like 12, 13 years old. One of the biggest, I guess I could say, turning points was I was getting in trouble in school, in high school, and an English teacher, you know, she really liked the way I wrote. And she took one of my poems. There was an assignment that we were doing for our class. And she took one of my poems and she was like, I really like this poem. I want to submit it to a contest.
Okay.
And the contest was about, it was something about diversity and it had something to do with like Martin Luther King Day.
Okay.
So she submitted the poem. My poem got picked for honorable mention by CMU for the Martin Luther King Day celebration. And they asked me to come up there University and like read my poem. So like that's one of the first, that was when I knew that if my hobby or something I just like to do was like, if Carnegie Mellon University
right.
is recognizing me at 14 years old,
yeah.
then like I know writing is something that like I should follow, you know what I mean? So like after that it's just like more opportunities, journalism opportunities. I always like, I was on and off with the poetry thing because it was like, I don't know if I can make money at it. And then sometimes poetry is not one of those things that like a lot of people are into.
Right, right.
So sometimes I would be like kind of hesitant to let people know that I did poetry. But a couple years later in high school, there was a poetry club and where we would like bring our poems to the club and like do them every week and critique each other's poems and stuff like that. So that's when I really like got into them. It was like, all right, there's people who are out here who are like me who write poetry, so like that sense of community was real important.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
Right.
Like, how'd you get involved with doing the music side of things?
Well, Mars Jackson is like, you know, that's my brother. That's like my best friend. He's my former roommate, former classmate. We used to go to college together.
Yeah.
So it was like a lot of things that he was doing naturally. If I was with him, you know what I mean, I'd either be helping him or I'd be like bouncing ideas to him. He'd be telling me ideas. So we've always like been like, our friendship has always been like a working friendship. So it's like, if he's doing something, I'm trying to help him get better. And if I'm doing something, he's trying to help me get better. So the high class society thing kind of came about like, I say maybe a couple months ago, maybe like at the beginning of this year, where it was just like, a bunch of people that we work with that are friends that we collaborate with. It's like, you know, everybody has a name for their thing and we never really had no name for our thing.
Right.
What people gotta understand, like, branding is very important. Because if you don't know how to brand yourself, if you don't have a brand, then it's really hard to market yourself too.
Yeah, it's hard for people to like to hone in like what you do.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right, because they can't put a finger on it.
Speaking of creative content, you just dropped a video. Well, you dropped 3 videos.
Yeah.
In the past like 2 months.
Yeah.
Like rappers don't even do that. You
right,
know what I'm
right,
saying?
You're
like
right.
the Gucci of this
He's
shit.
Stupid.
So you just dropped 3 videos, TMDW you did with Jimmy Jam. You dropped another one, No Fly Zone, just recently dropped
right.
with Tuffy.
Mm-hmm.
Derek, shout out to Derek Kenzel and Tuffy.
Shout out to DS Kenzel, man. That's my bro too.
Yeah.
That's my bro too.
Sure. And then you dropped your feature joint was I Don't Like.
Right.
What would you do if your son was at home? Crying all alone on the bedroom floor, cause he's hungry. But you Louie and Truie down, fucking with Instagram models. Popping bottles to celebrate why you ain't shit. Nigga, you ain't no father, my nigga, you's a bitch. Claiming you flipping bricks, but can't buy your son no kicks, see? This the type of man that don't deserve to have his dick. I was raised by men who took care of their own, but all you new niggas care about is the newest iPhone. As your offspring yearns for the love you never give, I can understand why queens abort so many kids. No king, so no kingdom, cause y'all fuck around with y'all freedom. Lusting to be gangster while you hang from trees and threesomes. Sambos, huh, wanna be Rambos with no respect is how I treat them. Our black nation is at war and you niggas committing treason. All doped up on trees and y'all don't know y'all seeds and play dads once a season. But we know how these scenes end. And miss me with that bro. My BM be tripping shit. If you love and respected her, you wouldn't be in that predicament. It seems like I'm angry because I'm militant. Cause I know the master used to take our men and clip they nuts ignorant. It's cousin Tuskegee, they gave our men syphilis. Flooded hoods with dope, then locked us up like hypocrites. A lot of talking, but I'm living it. Fatherless boys turn into men when no one's protecting their innocence. So in a sense, I'm just gonna be brief. The aftermath of crack cocaine is what raised Chief Keef. And that's that shit I don't like.
Thanks for tuning in today to Prez 7-7. Check us out every other week, you know what I'm saying, in September. Definitely have more videos coming for you. So make sure you check us out. Follow us on Twitter. All right, the last video I'm going to go to, my man Norman Dean. Joint's called Law. Shout out to Norman Dean. Yo, and appreciate the sponsors, imoveilive.com. IPOPGH.com. So check those guys out. Shout out to Brain of BMW too. Good looking guys. Let's go.
This is the highest cost. Take you and make you off. Let you and leave you lost. Will you forgive me? This is the highest cost. Take you and make you off. Let you and leave you lost.
She told me she ain't never had a nigga like I. Told me I'm quite fly, I'm digging a nice vibe. Thinking she might ride for a nigga on the low. She nothing like a hoe, she just all about a dough. And she don't give a fuck what these bitches gotta say. Long as she on the way, tomorrow's another day. Say she hate niggas, but I'm nothing like them other dudes. Hit her like I'm coming through and leave her when he done with you. Baby, I'm a G, keep it funky when I come around. You saving up so you can fly out to another town. Say she had it with these niggas, always playing games. She need a change, cause these niggas seem to stay the same. Girl, I feel you ain't never lied. The way you speaking when we creeping got me mesmerized. Just tell these other niggas step aside, cause baby you was right next to I.
This is the highest cost. Take you and make you off. Left you and leave you lost. Will you forgive me? This is the highest cost. Take you and make you off. Left you and leave you lost.
She say this shit ridiculous, she can never get a break. Say she's sick and tired of being another pretty face. Getting no respect cause she caught up with a lame boy. But I ain't the same boy, see me and she asked me what's your name. Boy, I can see she playing hard to pull. I know that brain probably better than a Harvard school. But she ain't nothing like them bitches from around the way. Sometimes she on the low but she gon' run the town today. Cause she don't give a fuck, she just try and live it up. Been fucking with her for some months, she wasn't tripping once. I give it up for